What is up, guys and gals? Dusty Novels here, bringing you a new story today called Where Are the Beasts? And before we get started, I have a question. And that is, what creature did you see at the very end of this story? Please explain in the comment section in detail. I'm excited to see what you came up with, and I'll let you know what I saw. But without further ado, here we go. This planet has wind. This planet has water. This planet has fields upon fields of thorny yellow trees, and frothing oceans covered in orange algae, and mountains that are more ice than rock. This planet has life. This planet has cities, great, sprawling cities that the hands of Earth's finest architect could not create, a beauty that Earth's finest artist could not put to paper. This planet has monoliths that reach toward the heavens in great spirals, structures that were clearly built by intelligent life. This planet has everything that ours does, only greater, stranger, and more beautiful. The more that we discovered this planet did have, the more we were confounded by what it didn't. There weren't any animals. No four-headed fauna gazing through the meadows of tall white grass. No fanged and scaly monsters soaring through the dark gray clouds. No leviathans lurking beneath the stormy orange seas. But the cities were empty too. Each and every edifice they had built to scrape the skies were found empty. Marvels of technology had gone into erecting these structures, and each tower was filled with hints as to how this species lived. They had foods, fruit with thick hides that could only be eaten by razor-sharp teeth. They had tools shaped to accommodate great slashing claws, and even a language they had neatly etched onto tablets. But there was no one there to explain it to us, no leader to be taken to, no one to which we might utter the words that have been itching on our tongue since we first crawled from the caves, "We come in peace." No one. It was as if the entire species had vacated just before our arrival, as if they had vanished into the world's frigid and unbreathable wind. Our confusion only grew as we searched the towers for signs of life, only to find each one unfalteringly empty. When we reached the very last level of the very last building, we sat back, puzzled and alone on this cold, empty planet. We sat there in silence, and then we looked up. Oh God. And then we looked up.